Hello, and welcome back to another Make It Monday. My name is Erin Lincoln, and today I'm going to show you how to reverse mask. If you look at those hearts from Love Tags 2010, you'll see that they have some patterns in them, and that is the technique that we will be learning today. Those are things that I added using a masking technique. If you notice, there's some gingham, some damask designs, and some turning a new leaf there that we're adding to our hearts. Starting out with an A2 card base, I have trimmed a half an inch off one side, and you'll see why later. All right, I'm getting my heart. Again, that's Love Tags 2010. We're going to stamp it 3 times. Now, when you're lining things up and trying to center them, I find it useful to always stamp your center image first. It's easier to find the center than it is to judge where the sides are and equally space everything. Just a little tip for you. Using True Black ink. And there's my third. Next, we're going to use a sentiment from Signature Greetings. It's I Love You So Much. Again in black. And that basically makes up the foundation of our card. Now, using a stack of large post-it notes, I'm going to stamp this heart one more time, and I am stamping it up on this sticky edge. That's just going to help me out here in a little bit. Just put everything away real quick. Alright, and what we're going to do is we're going to trim out, using some scissors, the center of that heart. Notice I just cut right into it. I'm not worried about a seam because the sticky edge of that post-it note is really going to help me out in sealing that when we use it to mask. Now this heart has a scalloped border, and I am leaving the scalloped border on the post-it note because I do not want any color there. I want it to look white on my card because I'm using a white card base. So that's behind, being left behind, and I'm only taking off the center of the heart here. And you can just disregard that heart, and now you have like a negative image. Gonna bring our card base back. You're going to line your mask now on top. And you see how that sticky edge keeps it in place for me and seals that seam. Alright, I'm putting on a foam mat so my inked images really transfer from my stamps. I'm just adding some more post-it notes to protect my white card surface. Alright, background basic gingham. Using Raspberry Fizz here. If you notice, I'm just going to ink up part of the stamp because I don't need the whole strip inked up. I'm going to press down really hard. Because of that mask, I want the ink to transfer as close to the edge of the mask as possible, and that is why I'm putting a little extra pressure and the foam mat behind it. And still, the little corner doesn't have the stamp, but this is such a forgiving technique here in addition to the ink application. Then it doesn't really matter. So I'm using a Ranger Ink Essentials ink applicator. I applied some Raspberry Fizz to it, and now I am in a circular motion going over my gingham in the same color. But with the ink applicator, it's going to be a softer shade. And so you're still going to have that kind of tone-on-tone look, even though you're using one ink pad. Just going it over it. Circular motion works best. Betsy did a whole video on using this tool, so you might want to check that out. That was another Make It Monday. Right, I'm going to remove all my masks and extra papers here to see what we have. All right, we're just going to reuse the mask. Okay, this is bothering me just a little bit. There's a little white edge up there. I'm just going to go back real quick and fix it. Again, very forgiving. I'm not even getting the mask down properly. Just on that one edge I'm concerned with. A little elbow grease, and it's going to take care of that little like halo look. See, really easy to fix. Alright, moving on. This middle heart is going to be stamped in a hibiscus burst. Once I get all my and a damask design, which is actually kind of heart-shaped itself, that stamp, and symmetrical, so it was really kind of like the perfect pick we go. That's Hibiscus Burst. The ink on the stamp is going to be darker than the ink from the ink applicator. And my felt pad has Pure Poppy in the back. I'm going to save that for later. Get a fresh one. These things are cheap. A couple cents a piece. You get them at Michael's with a coupon. Checking my ink pad. And again, I'm just going to do the same thing, applying a light coating of Hibiscus Burst ink to the darker stamped image from the same ink pad for a tone-on-tone look. And moving on, you know, we're going to use this mask one more time, so it was totally worth cutting out that heart, the fussy cut. Make sure that mask is down flat as possible and as close to the image on your white card front as possible too, because you just get the better look there, the best look that you can. Okay, this is a turning a new leaf, just a little sprig there, and Pure Poppy. You notice I used three kind of different style stamps. A big background stamp, a stamp that was bigger than the heart shape that we were masking off, and one that is, you know, small and kind of more fussy in the application. Just for variety. All right, we're using our Pure Poppy felt pad. And a third time, we're just doing it again. Now, grand total, this card is probably taking me 10 minutes, and that's, you know, outside of the intellectually thinking about it. I realize there's some think time, and I had this planned out. But as far as actual work time with the tools and the techniques, you'll notice it's really not that bad. It's really doable for a quick project. And you get a lot of oomph for your time with this technique. All right, make sure there's no ink on your hands to ruin that pristine white work surface. Can't tell you how many projects I've ruined because of transfer of ink off my fingers. All right, I want some twine down the center of those hearts. I'm using a paper piecer to poke a hole at the seam. Now I have a four-hole button in Pure Poppy. The four holes is important. I'm threading two holes horizontally from each other instead of diagonally, going around the back through the hole I made, and then I'm gonna thread through those last two holes in a horizontal manner, again not diagonally, because I want to tie a bow, and this would make it the best way to get that bow looking straight across and not skewed. You know, bows are kind of fussy. They'll turn on you. But I end up with two threads that are horizontal on the card, and when I tie my bow, they're most likely gonna be front and center, and you know, the way it should look, instead of, you know, one loop going skyward and one going groundward. It's just, I hate bows. I really do. I'm so bad at tying them. They're not my favorite. So you have to develop techniques to make it a little less painless. Now this is kind of a turquoise baker's twine. I got it from my stash. I thought it would be the less predictable choice considering with the colors that I've already used on the card. I could have used a red or a black or a brown, but I felt the turquoise was unexpected and therefore kind of makes the card stand out a little bit more, and that's why I chose it. Just trimming things up. Now, if you remember, this started out as an A2 card that I cut a half inch off, and that was because of this scalloped edge that I've die cut. I used the large scallop border and then cut it to fit, so it's going to take up the whole back of the card front and cover up the baker's twine. It's kind of a twofer. And down it goes. And the scallop border makes it a true A2 card and will fit in an envelope. There you go. You have learned this fabulous technique today. You really get a lot of out of your stamps with all the neat combinations you can come up with. And like I said before, it really only took me 10 minutes, so it's not a time-heavy technique. You can do this and hit it out of the park in no time flat. All right, so I'm interested in seeing what cards you create this week and which combinations you come up with the whole stamp catalog we have and what you have in your stash. And thanks for joining us again this morning, and we'll see you again next Monday with another Make It Monday technique video. Take care now.